Guys, how's it going? My name is Mittens, and welcome back to the Nostarius WoW Vanilla WoW practice server. Let's play on our rogue. As you can see here, it looks like I'm on some kind of dungeon, some kind of raid with all these people here. But no, we're just trying to kill Maggot Eye here in the Tirisfal Glades. I just thought this was worth showing, so it just goes to show how many people are here and just how insane things are right now. But I really like it. There's nothing better in an MMO than feeling like you're surrounded by people who are wanting to do the content together. It is a really good feeling. I also just wanted to show everybody a bit more Vanilla WoW in Tirisfal before we move on to, I guess, Silverpine. Because Tirisfal Glades in Vanilla was a really, really good zone. I really liked it. I really love the theme of the undead, as I've said before. And you'll get to see Brill, which is fantastic. So, right now we're just waiting for him to respawn. It's been a while. I'm in a party of five. Just checking what's the group loot. Yeah, group loot, that's okay. I'm in a party of five, but there are still at least three people here who are not in the party, and any one of them could tag this mob, and so everyone's a bit on edge. I'm gonna try and get it first. I've got my fingers over the tab target button and the number one so I can sinister strike it immediately. But there's another rogue right here. So, we'll see. If he ever does respawn, that is. Could take no time, could take a load of time. We'll see. It's really nice to see so many people here, but it's kind of funny because in this part of the game, right, in Vanilla WoW, the world feels so vast, even though obviously they hadn't a added things like Outland, Northrend, so ever. But the world feels more vast because people can't just like ride around on flying mounts, and people don't get a good mount until level 40. So seeing like an orc and a troll is like, oh my god, what the fuck are these guys doing here? These foreign people, but. Yeah, this is fucking mental. Look at all these people. I'm tempted to sack it off, you know, just to go away and try and finish off some quests. Oh yeah, I should say as well. As you can see, I'm wearing some nice gear. I did pick leatherworking. I have got my leatherworking and skinning. Oh god, yep, they're gonna be coming back now. Oh, these cops disappeared. I'll talk about leatherworking in a minute. God, I hope we actually get the hit here. I don't know what Maggot Eye even drops, but I think he's rare. So, come on, come on, come on. Any minute now. I feel like I'm about to pull a raid boss rather than like a level 11 rare. Come on, I could use this just for the XP. God, people getting in the fighting stance. There's a Rotthide down there. People are leaving, but I think it's people from my group. It's not good. Sure, any minute now, Maggot Eye's just going to appear in the middle of everybody, just over there to the left of me, and I hope I get the first hit. If I don't, I'm just leaving straight away. Just fuck it. It's not been a waste of time because you guys have gotten to see all of this, just see this like demonstration of the low-level population of the game, which is fantastic. Yeah, I may as well actually talk about leatherworking. So I decided to pick leatherworking skinning, and already by level 8 I've gotten them really high, and the reason why that is that there's so many people around here killing dust bats and wolves and stuff as part of the quests that I've literally just been able to run around skinning every single looted corpse. It's absolutely fantastic. So my skinning got to like 75 straight away. God's sake, I thought that was somebody pulling Maggot Eye. Where the fuck is he? He should be here now. Don't know how long his respawn timer is, but it can't be any different to normal mob, surely. Hopefully people will lose interest. And I'll probably be one of them. The music's so good here too. Really does help set the atmosphere of the Tirisfal Glades. Oh shit, there's more people here now. There's like 10 people. Ah, for fuck's sake. Oh shit. No, fuck off. Fuck it. Did we get anything from him? What the fuck? They were in another party? Oh, fuck off. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed the the little mini raid we did there. Got fucking ninja looted on, but that's the way it goes. I'm gonna just do a slash cry. So as you can see, guys, we're here now in the wonderful Gallows End Tavern, a lovely holiday destination for anybody wanting to spend time with the undead. Here in the beautiful village town of Brill, and as you can see, things are just as you remember them. Now, if we have another look through here, you can just see how many people are still leveling. Bear in mind that I'm actually currently playing at 1:02 in the morning on a Monday morning server time, so this is what it's like at that time in the morning on a Monday. And here we are. I just had to let you guys see this. This is that fantastic village of Brill. This is one of the most iconic locations in the game, and it's fantastic to be able to come back here after the changes that have been made. As I've said several times before, I will say it once again, the thing that I loved so much about the Forsaken up until around Wrath of the Lich King was that they were this niche force fighting against these insurmountable odds. They had the Scourge oppressing them from all sides, the Scarlet Crusade, and the Alliance. And you can tell that so well by the fact that they still live in these rotted out homes. And that kind of lovely haunted feel is what makes me play a Forsaken all the time. As you can see, we've got loads of quests to do. I am nearly level 10. When we get to level 10, I'll make sure to show you what happens. But for now, let's go ahead and get on with some quests. So we are going to head east. Most people go west. They go up to the Aggerman Mills, and they might go north to Garen's Haunt. We are going to go east. We've got a couple of quests to do. We're not going to head towards the Scarlet Monastery, because that's not a good idea. A quick way to get yourself killed. Just seeing all of these guilds that are advertising on the server, it's pretty awesome. And people wanting to group up and do quests, because, like, I know it's early on, but it's great to see that the population is already thriving. I mean, somebody was saying that earlier on the afternoon, on the Sunday afternoon, they had 6.3k players. That's fucking fantastic. And if you think that there's no cross-server stuff, you'll make friends really quickly, which is absolutely awesome. Anyway, we have got a quest at War with the Scarlet Crusade, and I've obviously played a bit, played about 4 or 5 hours since the last video. Fucking hell, someone warlock over there racing to try and get my kills, no doubt. And I've got a couple of quests. The one with At War with the Scarlet Crusade is at the part where I've got to clear out the Scarlet Crusade Tower in southeastern Tirzfall Fall, which I think is somewhere around here. It might not be near the Bulwark, but we're going to go to the Bulwark first because we have another quest nearby. And I'm trying to maximize the amount of footage I have in Tirzfall Fall because it is a really iconic zone. We will, of course, be traveling to Silverpine Forest next. But I think, you know, I'm going to do some questing in this episode, and then after that, I'll probably end it with going to the mighty Undercity for the first time, which gives me chills the thought. So there's Plaguelands, Undercity, Brill. Ugh. Don't look at the Plaguelands. Where's this place? Is this the place I need to go to? No, this is Balnear Farmstead, and I have a quest. I have a quest, and I think that's the tower there. Awesome stuff. Awesome stuff. And there's Lordamere Lake. I was reading the Rise of the Lich King book the other day, and questing through Tirzfall Fall just makes me appreciate it even more because obviously some of these places are in the book. And I really love playing Forsaken. Forsaken Master Race. Oh god, this guy's level 11. But I do have a really good weapon that I got, so hopefully I'll be able to sort him out. I love the challenge that I get from Vanilla WoW, just killing NPCs or mobs. It kind of reminds me weirdly of Dark Souls. Like, there's a really high difficulty curve, but I think it's maybe just it's a unique thing. It's fantastic. What's that? Warped leather? Ooh, is that better than what I have on? 39. I think it is. So that's 39 reinforced with 8, and they're 36 reinforced with 8. What am I talking about? That's retarded. Where's my logic? I don't have any. Right, I've got to watch out though. I am going to hit level 10 pretty quickly, killing these guys, but that should be good enough. Should be able to kill this guy. Oh, he's only level 10, less health. I am really looking forward to hitting level 10. Getting to make some choices. Getting dual wield. I'm pretty sure it's at level 10 on the rogue you get dual wield, which should be fantastic because we're doing a load of damage as is. Dual wield should be fantastic. We should be doing loads and loads and loads of damage. What do we have to kill? 8 bleeding horror, 8 wandering spirits. That's a bleeding horror right there. I'm gonna let my health get up. No, fuck it. gonna pop a bandage because I've got loads. I also love, I was telling my friend this the other day, I was talking to him about this. He was telling me how he's enjoying WoD at the moment, and I was just talking to him about how I'm really enjoying just taking a break and starting on this server. And the main reason why is because, like, the thing about vanilla is that it makes you really appreciate the holistic RPG elements of World of Warcraft. And what I mean by that is, look at me. I'm level 9. I'm wearing a full set of all leather working gear that I've made myself. I've got leather working at 65 out of 75, so already nearly a gentleman. I've already got journeyman skinning. I've got first aid going on. You know, it's just things like that. I've already been to Orgrimmar, although I haven't shown you that. That was fun. I'll show you that later. I've already been to Orgrimmar. You know, I've had to make all these decisions, and I've already fleshed out my character in a lot of detail, despite the smaller amount of mechanics that existed in the game. And this is what I say when I talk about what I like about vanilla. It's mainly the fact that you're pushed to do things that you're no longer pushed to do, and you're pushed into enjoying being submerged in a world with difficulties and tasks. I think it must be similar to people who play, for example, DayZ, where you have to struggle and you have to go out on a limb in order to survive. And it is awesome. It's exactly what you want when you play in a game like this. You play an MMO, and what you want is a population of active people who you can make friends with, and really good content that keeps you in and keeps you wanting to do more than just log on to do your raids. And this offers that, and I'm really happy with it. So, now that I've had my philosophy moment for the day, we're just gonna kill these spirits, and then after that, we should probably hit level 10, and then we'll go back to Brill, and I will show you what happens when we hit level 10, and then we will get on with some more questing, and then finally, it'll be time to go to the Undercity. First, die, wandering spirit. That's what I'm talking about. Well, here we are, we're about to hand this quest in, and with that, we should hit level 10. This is gonna be pretty cool. Let's do this. Vethgard Linnea, lovely sword. Do you have a report? Yeah, I do. Very good, your efforts do much to keep the Scourge at bay. A commendation will be sent to my superior, Executor Zygarde. Boom, bitch! And the main reason why I want to show you this is because you know what time it is. It's talent time. Now, obviously, for those of you who've seen any of my other playthroughs, or played vanilla, or seen anything vanilla, you don't choose a specialization per se. You can put points into any one of the three. And in a sense, that's far more complex than WoW has ever been since. And I absolutely love it. This system is the best. So let's have a quick look through the talents as we make our way back to Brill. First one in assassination is increases the damage done by Eviscerate by 5%. I get the feeling that's a must, but I'm not going to take it yet. I'm going to see what else there is. Remorseless attacks after killing an opponent that yields experience or honor gives you a 20% increased quick strike chance on your next sinister strike, backstab, ambush. Seems pretty alright. Very good in PvP, I should think. Increases your critical strike chance by 1%. Combat. Increases the duration of your gouge by 0.5, reduces the cost of sinister strike by 3, increases dodge chance by 1, and subtlety reduces the chance enemies have to detect you while in stealth mode. I really like that. I'm not going to pick it yet, but I just like the roleplay, like the RPG-esque nature of that, you know, like it's not a case of like when you're in stealth, when you get stealth, you're just undetectable and it stays the same forever and you're just undetectable unless you got right in front of someone. It's like you can put points into improving your stealth. I really like that. Or increases the damage dealt when striking from behind. Okay, well, I'm gonna go with the decreased sinister strike because it seems the most economical right now and the best. And I'll probably put 5 in there, then go straight to assassination and put 5 in the put 3 in the improved eviscerate. And that's the sort of thing that I mean. That's the sort of thing that I really like about this. So let's quickly, before we go on to the next quest, let's quickly go up in here and see. We've been stashing a little bit of silver, nearly at 30 silver, check me. Ooh, got a quest. Malevolus, not quite what I was expecting, considering Karkad himself has taken an interest in you. Looks can be deceiving though, right? Either way, you should go see him as soon as possible. You wouldn't want to know what happened to the last few that ignored his orders. So that's another reason to go to the Undercity, to meet with the guy in the Rogue's Quarter, and this will be our first class quest. Really looking forward to this, guys. As you know, every class has its own class quests in vanilla, and it's fantastic, really. Can't say much else. We can get slice and dice for taking that. One thing that I'm really enjoying, sprint definitely. One thing that I'm really enjoying about playing on this server rather than Warsong at the moment is just the fact that I can now dual wield. No, is the fact that I am saving up a lot of money through questing, which means that I can afford to get my abilities as they come, which is fantastic. And I'll just take sap too. Awesome, let's quickly just alter our action bars. Slice and dice can go there. And sprint. Just put that in the shift one for now. Okay, guys, now let's get back on with it. I hope you really enjoy now the fact that we're in level 10. I'm really happy. Okay, so I think now's the time that we go to the Undercity. We've got a few things that we need to do. We've got to talk to Bethor Ice Shard, I think it is. Yeah, and we've got to talk to Menet Karkad, cool ass name. And also, it'll give me the opportunity to learn some new leatherworking stuff. Because currently, I've learned everything that the trainer can do outside Undercity. Hopefully, there's one inside. I hope that it's just not just that that's the only one here, because she only does apprentice leatherworking stuff. Which is kind of bad. I have not slept in several days, but it's worth it. And no, I don't mean like I've been awake for several days and have only now got to level 10. That would be pretty disappointing. No. I've just been unable to sleep. So many rogues. It seems that everybody's just a rogue or a priest. Fortunately, I don't think many of these people will make it to level 60, or at least not all of them. And that might sound like a bleak outlook on life, but you know, getting to level 60 is a lot harder than it thinks it sounds. I mean, in my opinion, getting to level 60 takes just as long, if not longer, than it does to get to level 100 in retail. Well, probably a lot longer, actually. You can easily get to level 40 in a day in retail now. If you've got full heirlooms, you can get to level 40 in a day or further. Yeah, you can level to 100 in about a week. And that's just a normal person. Normal person, not like a guy who knows exactly where to go, what to do. Could level 2. Get level to 100. Oh, get through, get through, get through! Oh, yes. Can level to 100 in about a week. But, to get to level 60? I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Maybe it just depends on the person. But first, okay. Let's just check to see if we can get to. Is that broken? Have I found a bug? Oh, they won't tell me where the profession trainers are. That's not good. We'll have a quick look about. Do we have goods to sell, first of all? Yeah, we do have a few goods. We have a few goods to sell. It's nice to see so many people in the Undercity as well, actually. For a change. I don't expect there to be many people online because it is like 2:30 on a Monday. There's still nearly 4,000 people online and at least 50 in the Undercity. This is awesome. Okay. Sell the frayed pants, sell the journeyman's boots, sell the forest mushroom cap. Sell Tiger's Eye. Ooh, or maybe keep the Tiger's Eye and try to auction it. Maybe that's a good plan. Sell the warm leather gloves. Okay. I love this music. It really makes me want to raid Naxx, but Naxx is obviously the last place we've got to go to. So, ooh, look at these badass level 30s. I like how I've not seen anybody higher than level 40 yet. I think, actually, yeah, that's a lie. I think I've seen one level 44 warrior. And that's it. And I really like that. I love that this is basically how it is at the start of vanilla. I really like that because I never got to appreciate that with other servers. Okay, let's just go straight to Betharai Shard first of all. Actually, no, we're right next to the rogue place. So. We'll just sweep around. We'll sweep around. Let me just see what the prices of Tiger's Eye are actually first. First and foremost. What's the point in putting it on the auction house for the same price that you can vendor it? What's the point in putting it on the auction house for less than you can vendor it? Economics. Can you do it? Obviously not. Okay, so here we are in the wonderful Undercity. Fortunately, Undercity not very changed, despite the rest of Tyr's Fall and the Undead Lands being changed a lot post-Cataclysm. Tyr's Fall, I mean, the Undercity, pretty much the same. Which is awesome, because the Undercity is the best city, right? It might be abandoned, but it is the best city. I just really look forward to, like, the period of Naxx and stuff, when everyone will be in the Undercity because of how close it is. There we go, is that Menet Karkad? It is. I'm about to get a quest. I think this might be picklocking, perhaps? We shall see. Menet Karkad, what have you got to say? Yeah, no doubt you made your sway here, yeah. Oh, prospective Deathstalker, loving it. If you wish to join the Deathstalkers, Lord Varimathras Elite Guard, you will have to prove your worth. I will not lie to you, this task could mean your death. I have some things that need attending to. I require the personal effects of Astor Hadron, a messenger who travels between Silverpine and the Undercity. I will leave the method of procurement to your discretion. It will be better for you if you know less of the nature of this business. Succeed and I shall tell you more. Nice. I'm going to leave that for a bit though, because it seems pretty difficult. But can I get any... learn any things? No. Nope. I just forgot that you get upgraded stealth, not only just in talent form. Put our first talent into combat, of course. This city is fantastic. You can totally imagine this being like the... In like the Rise of the Lich King book, this place is basically what you might think it would be. It's the sewers, and it's basically where they house Orgrim Doomhammer, where they keep him captive. And it's also where all the vagrants and stuff live. And I'm pretty sure it's Arthas himself who comments, like, when he's just a kid, that he didn't understand how anybody could live down in the Undersea. Which I think is pretty awesome, because, like, obviously they then go on to do so. I'm just going to quickly check around the Rose Quarter, because I think that might be where there's a leather-working person. There's a first aid trainer there. Could probably get a new first aid recipe, but... yeah, there we are. Yes. Awesome. You can't train me because you're an apprentice. But you can. Awesome. Worth it. What can I get? Nothing. I need to have skill 80. What do I have now? Skill 70 or something. 65. Okay. Well, we'll just have to keep it where it is for now. Let's go and talk to Bethor Ice Shard, which is a really cool name. And we're about to embark, I think, on one of my favourite quests, the Prodigal Lich, which I remember doing all the way back in the Burning Crusade and absolutely loving it. It was a fantastic quest, and it really highlighted the nature of the Forsaken, broken and divided, with people outside of the Forsaken, free undead, who had no idea whether or not they were free, who was free as well, who was a liar, who was a servant of the Lich King. And this is where you get a really good display of that. You can see also people have been doing the warlock quests around here too, which is pretty damn cool. But yeah. I just love the busyness of activity that's going on. It's fantastic. Okay. Greetings. Either you do not know who I am, or your business with me is urgent. Because if neither of these are true, then you would not be foolish enough to disturb me. Ooh, one of those guys. Okay. There is a lich who dwells on an island in Brightwater Lake to the north. Although he is a free-willed lich, he believes all other undead are scourge slaves and had his minions attack anyone who approaches him. But because he is forsaken, the queen will want him, and if he is skilled in necromancy, then his knowledge to us could be quite useful. To discover his identity and his talents, I must steal his spellbook, steal it into his camp and acquire it, then return to me. You see, you can see there. Left in days. You can see the seeds of Sylvanas' plans to raise new Forsaken, to solve the plight of the Forsaken, as she put it herself, through creating new undead. It's another thing that I really like and appreciate about the Forsaken, particularly in the vanilla game. In Burning Crusade, obviously nothing changes, so it is vanilla really that I'm talking about. In vanilla, you can clearly see the Forsaken trying to figure out ways to stave off their own inevitable death. They are literally pressed from all sides by unassailable foes. You've got the Scarlet Crusade, which at this time are huge in number. It's pretty much anybody who who stayed in Lordaeron and wanted to fight. You've got the Scourge, who are trickling in, so much so that they've already penetrated a lot of a large portion of the Tirith Fell Glades. You know, you've got the Alliance coming from the south, and then you've got the problem, of course, of the fact that the Forsaken, like all undead, whilst essentially immortal, will slowly lose their sanity.
Watch your sanity.
Right, here we are. Okay, so we've done our little first trip to the Undercity there. And I think... one thing I noticed is that when I travelled over to the Balnear farmstead that you saw earlier, there was very few other people questing there. A lot of the people are currently clustered around Bryll, the Bryll-related quests, like the level 8-9 quests mainly, and also in Deathknell. Deathknell, as you saw in the first video, was absolutely packed with people. And I think the reason why this is A, it's the starting zone, and B, once people get to level 10, a lot of them want to try and rush into Silverpine, a lot of them go to the Barrens, to Durotar, to experience the other questing and things like that. I am going to stay in Tirith Fell for a bit, for a couple of reasons. Firstly, I really love the zone. I think the zone is one of my favourites. But secondly, I think it's a lot easier if I do some of the quests up until when they're green. Just get these yellow quests done, which will be easy but still will reward a lot of XP, before trying to rush into Silverpine and maybe being stalled by the difficulty. But we have our dual wield daggers now, and I am happy. Okay, so now that we've been to the Undercity, where can we go? Captain Vakenstrain. Yeah, I think I'm going to do this at War with the Scarlet Crusade, and then I might check out the Bulwark. And while we're there, we can look at Brightwater Lake, which is this huge pond in the centre of Tirith Fell, and is a place that I really, really, really particularly like. In fact, how difficult is that quest? Lich's Identity? No, it's just yellow. I think we will go and test out our new dual wield on this awesome quest, the Prodigal Lich. First, I'm just going to try and kill a Dark Hound. He's only level 5, so it's half my level, but I want to see how much damage I do dual wield now. Yeah, a lot. Oh, and I've got Slice and Dice too, haven't I? Almost forgot. Always skin it. The amount of things I've been able to skin just because people killing all of these Dusk Bats for the quest. For the woman who gives you a cloak. Awesome stuff. I've also got fishing. I also started getting fishing, by the way, but I tried to do that earlier, and... yeah, fishing. Not too fun. I'm gonna kill this bat and I'm gonna quickly just show you something. Take his patch of hair. Okay. Now, if we go over to the Shortest Lake, we'll see what I was gonna say. This visual that you're seeing right here is part of the reason why I really, really love the Tirith Fell Glades, more so than a lot of regions. It has the same feel in both the Western and Eastern Plaguelands, but only in Vanilla, because after Vanilla they get really busy. The Eastern Plaguelands not so much, but the Eastern Plaguelands starts to feel a bit like, oh, it's being saved, and the Western Plaguelands is definitely being saved and is really, really, really busy. But in Vanilla, those three zones, but especially this one in my opinion, just have that bleak emptiness to them. Like, you can just imagine in real life just sitting on the shores of this lake surrounded by this decaying forest, and it just feels like something out of a horror story, and I really, really, really appreciate that. It's a sort of theme that I particularly enjoy. Okay. Right. What's this chat? Kalimdor's starting zone must be cramped. Of course it's cramped. People saying it's just orcs and trolls. That's a really stupid, and no one plays trolls. Well, to begin with, if you think that you've only got 5 races to choose from, and I know because I've seen many trolls so far that were just here in Tirith Fell, people will be playing trolls because trolls have the best racials if you want to be a rogue. Right? If you want to be a combat rogue, trolls and orcs have by far and away the best racials. And everybody knows that. So yes, it will be very cramped. And also the reason why it'll be cramped is because everybody plays orcs. After humans, before Blood Elves came out, orcs were by far and away the second most popular race. So, no. Fool. Fool. Okay, so what we have to do is steal this guy's spellbook. I think he's asleep when I steal this spellbook, which is pretty funny. I'm going to kill these shambling horrors. Get some slice and dice built up. Okay. I know now when you play WoW in retail, slice and dice basically seems to go on forever. Maybe we have to improve it first before that happens. Okay. Can we not loot him? There we go. Heal him. Do a little bit first aid. No use to not use first aid right now. No point in it. Because... Gunther Arcanus. Cool name. You see, if there was some kind of territory staking thing in WoW, like if you could claim land and like for your guild or whatever and like do world PvP there, I would totally claim this island because it's just badass. I've really missed it. I haven't come back to this island since the Burning Crusade, now that I think about it. Anyway, that's his spellbook. He is looking right at me. There is a corpse right there, so I get the feeling he's going to kick off. He's level 53 as well, so... This is the most hidden roguish activity ever. Lol. Okay. Bye-bye, mate. I think he must have thought I was one of his servants or something. That's what we'll say, he thought. And I wonder what has to happen over here. I'm pretty sure there's a quest that you have to do over here. I mean, there's loads of dead bodies. I think these are dead bodies, not just skeletons. Yeah, there's definitely some dead bodies there. I'm sure you have to do a quest here and summon a beast. A beastie. But now we're going to go to do the next part. We're going to have another swim. And I think I will show a little bit more of that before I end the video. I've tried to do it in a few different clips this time. It takes a bit longer and takes a bit more time to... Ooh, look at that filler. Weird. Ugh. Yeah. Ooh, can you see? You can see all the way to Brill from here. I think. I'm pretty sure that's Brill. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I've tried to do it in a series of clips right now, and I apologise for how absolutely fucked up I seem right now. It's because I've been up for so long. But I've tried to do it in a series of clips because I think that gets you to see a lot more of what I've filmed rather than just a constant stream of stuff, especially when quests can take 5-10 minutes each to complete now. At least some take a lot longer. But I thought I'd show you a few things. The Undercity... This particular quest I really like. I'm not sure if I'll do another video in Tirith's Fall Glades or not. I mean, we are level 10 now. People just comment. I mean, there's been so many comments on the first video. The support has been overwhelming, guys, and I really, really do appreciate it. Another thing I will say, shout out to Garaku. Dude, that whisper that you sent me, awesome stuff, man. Really nice to see that the videos are appreciated, and that goes for everybody else who comments on the videos and subscribes as well. It really does mean a lot to me, and, I really like to see this channel grow. It would be really awesome. So, anyway. Enough of the sentimentality. There is killing to be done. Okay, Crusader Outpost. This is where we are supposed to be. All the ruined leather scraps. I'm just saving them up for now. Can't be asked to... them. It's hard, because I know I have to provide commentary. And I know everybody knows the nostalgia that we get from playing this, like, this kind of server. But it's hard not to, like, just be like, oh, I can't believe that I'm back here after so long. And that's such a great feeling to have. But it's not just that which makes me enjoy this server so far. It's the fact that I have that feeling of nostalgia and enjoyment in it. Not just nostalgia, not just thinking about it, but experiencing it, too. But I also get the feeling of knowing that I'm experiencing it with loads of other people who are also, like... really enjoying themselves, and it feels so fresh, and it feels like this is like something brand new, and I really enjoy it, and I hope that this continues to be this way through the playthrough on our masterful rogue. But yeah, what have I got to do now? Let's Scarlet Friar and Captain Vachon. I get the feeling that I might need help with Captain Vachon or Vachon or Vachon. Captain Vachon, these are Scarlet Zealots. There's a Friar over there, level 10. Friar over there, sitting in his chair. Oh, right, of course I don't. There's a guy here. Maybe group up with this individual? Is he going to decline? Oh, he's going to group up. Hopsy! Being a bro. Loving it. Come on, Hopsy, man. Oh, shit. Let's kill this dude. The amount of people that have been wanting to group up with each other as well in this starting zone is fantastic. Like, had people wanting to group up with me loads and loads of times. It's so, so good. It feels different than anything before. And the funny thing is that I was saying this to a friend the other day, is that it's better than WoD, or it's better than WoW, like, since about Wrath, I would say, because they've streamlined content in the vanilla in the retail game to the extent where you no longer need assistance to complete content. Outside of dungeons and raids, you don't need assistance to complete content anymore, and there aren't any what I would call group quests anymore. So, but now in vanilla, in this, you do need that assistance, and it means that you meet people, even if you don't make friends, even if you don't communicate with them in much detail beyond just inviting them to a group and knowing that you have to kill the same mobs. You experience what it's like to be in an MMO and to work with other people and to see them going along their journey too, which is what being in an MMO is all about after all. Yeah, we are just chilling with our main man Hopsy right now. The fuck is this? Do 5 days to 60. Guess there are some people who are already 60. I'd be surprised if there isn't. Just waiting for Captain Vacant to spawn. Right now. Some more fries to spawn. There's a fryer over there! There's a fryer over there, Hopsy! Hopsy!
Hopsy!
Am I gonna have to drag him? Am I making the pulls? I'm making the pulls. Come on, Hopsy, mi adore. Yeah, now you see it. Yeah, get your shadow spells on the go. I need to get some points into improved slice and dice soon, because I feel like rather than eviscerating it all, it's just all going straight into slice and dice. Ooh. I bet there's a really easy way to get experience here, which is just to group up with like a party of 5 level 10s and then just go to, say, Southern Silver Pine where the mobs are like level 18 and just farm level 18 mobs or something. Or just farm level 10 mobs and just kill loads and loads and loads of them. Is there anybody else around here, or is it just that Scarlet Zealot? I'm scared that Hopsy's gonna leave me. I need his support. Oh, there is. There's two of them. But you know Hopsy. We've seen him so far. He doesn't like to move. He's a stone cold killer. Come on. Come on, Captain Vacken. This is the funniest thing about this server so far, is that because it's so populated, people have just killed everything, and it takes ages for stuff to respawn. But yeah. Let's have a look at Hopsy. Unfortunate face. He has fake jaw, no eyes. It's tough, man. I personally have eyes, but a rotted jaw. No! Hopsy! Oh, yeah, Hopsy, you see. You see? Oh, Captain Vacken, you saw Captain Vacken. What level is Hopsy? He's level 10 too. Oh, look at this, we're absolutely pawning this guy's face. Fucking hell, Hopsy with the wand skills. Yeah, back when wands were useful. There's the other undamaged hippogriff feather. You know, I got another one of them, and I looked it up, and you can get them for a quest in Azshara. You need two of them for a quest. Ooh, Hopsy with his parkour skills. Are you off, mate? Oh. Oh, there we are. Disconnected. So I'm pretty sure we have one more thing that we have to do. You can see a level 38 warrior. Orc warrior over here, probably going to Scarlet Monastery. I'd be surprised if he wasn't. I'll follow in his wake. He won't lead us astray. He's got the Ravager on his back. Actually, no. It's Whirlwind Axe, I think. The one and only Whirlwind Axe. Loving it. We've got one more thing we've got to do at War with the Scarlet Crusade. We've got to kill this Captain Melraish and his two bodyguards, which are in Northern Tirisfal, and I'm pretty sure it's the tower which is over here in the north. Hopefully we'll find some people to help us out with this quest, but nice place to round off the play. This episode of the playthrough would be with a... killing the rest of the Scarlet Crusade in this area. God, look at this. Bodies hanging from trees, all this dark stuff going on. I don't think it's that way, because I'm pretty sure that's the Nightweb place, or whatever it's called. The Scarlet Monastery is obviously there. We may as well discover that whilst we're here, but we've got to go north, I think. I think we'll discover the Scarlet Monastery, though, just to have a nice look at it, if we can get close. I don't even know if we can get too close to it. I cannot wait to run Scarlet Monastery, though. It's going to be fantastic. and just to do other dungeons too. I would say this, guys, right now, because of the support I've gotten and the fact that there's quite a few people watching this playthrough, if you want to run a dungeon with me, or if you want to be in this playthrough at all, if you want to be seen in the playthrough, there's another person. Look at all these people probably running to the Scout Monastery. I'm going to follow them. Actually, no, I'm not going to follow them. There's elites over there. Fuck that. I'm going to go to where I've got to go, which is over here, I believe. But yeah. What I was saying, guys, is that Scarlet Watch Post, I assume that's where we've got to go. Right. I don't think I've actually been to the Scarlet Watch Post before. I don't think I went there in vanilla. I've obviously been there post Cataclysm. But I haven't gone in vanilla, so. Let's see what the situation is. Yeah, one thing that. Oh. Yeah, only level 11. I can handle that. Oh shit, there's two of them! Ah, fuck, I'm out of here. Sprint time! Let's get the fuck out of here. This is why I love sprint. I'm so glad that we've got the ability now. It just means that we can get out of combat so much easier. But yeah, what I was gonna say was that if you wanna be in this playthrough at all, guys. Oh, there we go. If you wanna be seen in the playthrough, if you wanna be in a video, if you wanna do a dungeon with me, or just do a bit of leveling with me or whatever, just. You know, add me on friends list on the server. You know what my name is. You can see there, it's my level list. So, we've got to kill Captain Melrash here and his two guards, and they are right up at the tower itself, I believe. This place is crawling with bloody people, annoyingly. We'll see how we can do. Get a slice and dice on. These guys have got armor, which is annoying. Just pop evasion. Lovely playing a rogue. Rogues feel really, really good to play, even in vanilla, which is fantastic. Ah, oh, shit, she's gonna run over there, isn't she? Jesus Christ. This is exactly what I need. I'm probably gonna die here. Yeah, I'm probably dead. If I can even run here, no, I can't. I've got no potions. I think this is us fucked. Yeah. Can they get that for Ifisri? Oh, yes, 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 yes. Die. Oh. Heal quick. Cannibalize too, I think. Cannibalize. Oh, yeah. Oh, that feels good. Okay, let's have a quick peek. Not sure how far we'll get here. As you can see, we're already nearly level 11, which is great stuff. Ah, God, there's people everywhere. I don't see any betrayed to do this quest either, but let's just see how far we can get. Maybe we can get a little bit closer. You know what? I'm backing off. I'm backing off. A rogue needs to know when to cut his losses, and I am not ready to do this quest yet. I'm going to move over down to the north, because I know that I have quests to do here still. And just tell me, guys, if you want to see any more of Tyr's Fall in the next episode. I might do another Tyr's Fall episode, or I might just wait until I'm at Silverpine, which shouldn't be very long at all. But yeah, guys, as always, please like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Please leave a comment. Tell me what you liked about the video. Tell me what you'd like to see in the next one. Any quests or any places you'd like me to go to, if you'd like to see Orgrimmar or anything like that. I really do appreciate the support, and thank you so much for what you've shown to me so far. I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.